Hi everyone, welcome to an introduction to Minizinc, the constraint modeling language. To install Minizinc in your computer, just go to minizinc.org and follow the simple steps in the software section to download and install it. Once you have it, just go to the Minizinc IDE provided by this software. In this IDE, as you can see, we have an editor to write our code. If you go to help, cheat sheet, you will find basic tutorials on how to create a model and the basic features of the Minizinc language. So now we are going to create our first model. Just click on New Model. And we are modeling the Send More Money problem. This problem is a typical problem in CP consisting of an anagram where each letter represents a digit from 0 to 9 and the sum of these numbers must hold. Having that in mind, first thing we do here is to put our first comment. For that, we use the percentage character and we write a heading explaining what the problem is, the authors of the problem with our names here, how we are modeling this problem, if using any special encoding or just straightforward from the problem definition. Yeah. Next thing, we define the variables of a problem. In this case, we have a variable for each letter of the anagram, and the variables contain an integer number, so we use the word var for defining a variable, followed by the type of the variable, in this case int, then we add a colon, and the name of the variable. The first letter is an s, so s, and a semicolon will close the definition of this line. But in this case, as we know that all the letters correspond to a number between 0 and 9, in Minizinc we can, instead of defining two constraints to limit the bounds of each variable, just define its domain as a range of numbers by using the expression 0.9 as its type instead of integer. Now here we put a comment about the variables we are defining. And now, as we are going to use this range many times in the model, one thing we can do to make this model cleaner is define a parameter for this range, which is basically a set of integers, so set of int, colon, and we call it digit, and this is defined as 0.9. We put a comment on it. And, well, as we can see, there is no var because this is a fixed parameter that we use to define some value that will be used in the model. So now we can just change the range in the variable to digit and define the rest of the letters of the anagram. Well, so now going with the constraints, the first thing to consider is that the variables s and m cannot be equal to 0. This can be defined as constraint, and the expression that must be whole, for example, in this case, s different from 0, or for example, bigger than 0. But here, there is another way to do this, which is defining a new parameter set called digit 1, for example, which has the range 1 to 9, and we change it in the letters S and M. This way, we can get rid of these constraints by just bounding the domain of the variables. So, going on, we now define the constraint of the sum in the anagram, the sum plus more equals money, where basically we can see that the S is in the thousands. So what we do is constraint and we multiply it by 1000. Then the E is in the hundreds, so we multiply it with 100 and so on. We can even make a line break as long as we don't add a semicolon. And this way, we will keep writing our constraint, but in a more clean way, so we can see exactly the same sound as we see in the anagram. And this will be equal to, and here we have 10,000, as money is composed of 5 letters instead of 4. More. And that will be it. So now, the only remaining constraint is to assure that all letters are different. And for that, we may just write for each pair of variables that they are different. And so we make each combination, and that will perfectly work. But the resulting model is quite long for potential readers, and in this case, there is a shorter way to do this by using global constraints. Global constraints are predefined functions that allow to define high-level constraints between several variables that make the code clearer and sometimes more efficient for some solvers, as these solvers have special, more efficient methods implemented for dealing with this special type of constraints. So for this case, there exists the all different global constraint that checks that all elements of an array are different, but we don't have an array, but several variables. So we must first define an array of size. Array of size 1 to 8, as there are 8 variables, of variable integer, and we call it letters, and we assign it to the letters of the anagram, the variables we've created. And yeah, this should be in brackets. We put a comment as always to explain what is this. And then just erase all the inequality constraints here. And instead, we write the old different constraint over the letters. And that will be it, except that global constraints are not included by default in our model. We need to include the library where this constraint is. I recommend to do it at the beginning, just after the heading. And here we will put include, and between quotation marks, the name of the library. We could just add global.mzn, which will include all the globals, which will include all the global constraint libraries, and we can use all of them, or just put the name of the concrete library we're using. In this case, all different.mzn. Yeah. Good. And now, the only remaining thing to try our model is to add the goal of the solver. So in this case, it is solve satisfy, as we just want to look for a solution of the CSP. But for optimization problems, you could define solve maximize or solve minimize and the variable or expression you want to optimize. So just with this, we first save our model. Put the name of the model, for example, sendmoremoney.mzn, always with this extension for models. And we just click on run using the default solver, Gcode, and we will obtain a solution for this problem. As can be seen, when we don't specify the output, by default, Minizinc shows the values of all the non-instantiate variables of the problem. If we want a different output, we go here and we use the output command, and in brackets as an array, we will write the different strings we want to represent. So for example, here we could write S between quotes, colon, and then to show the value of a variable, we use the command show and the variable. And with this, we will show the letter S. We do the same with the rest of letters to show them. Then by using backslash M, we make a line break. And here we can see a different way of representing, of showing the value of a variable inside the same stream by using backslash and between parentheses the name of the variable. And what we are representing here is the anagram sum when with the substitute numbers. So now we save, and if we run this again, we will now see the new results and also the form of the anagram after replacing them. We can also see that after that, there are some dashes in one line that represents the end of one solution, but it doesn't mean that there are no more solutions. If we click in the Show Configuration Editor, here we can specify how the running process works. First, we could select a different solver among the ones that Minizinc provides. We could also specify the time limit for that solver, and we can see that the default behavior is that for optimization problems, all intermediate solutions are printed, while for satisfaction problems, the process stops after the first solution found. So we're gonna define our own behavior, where we are gonna say that for satisfaction problem, all solutions are printed, that is with zero. And here, if we go on, we can see there are many other options, like for example, in solver options, we could specify the number of threads to run in parallel for the solver. With output statistic, we could show some additional statistic, like for example, the number of iterations of the algorithm on the number of nodes it has explored. If we click here in extra solver options, we can specify concrete options for that solver, like for example, the cutoff in the search or the number of restarts and no goods, etc. So now with this new configuration, we run the model again. And now we can see here these two lines of hyphens. That means that these are all the solutions already represented here. And we can see that for this problem, there is only one solved solution. But let's try some modifications in this problem to see more solutions. So what we are going to do here is to add a new parameter of type integer, call it base. And this parameter will represent the numeric base of the digits. So for example, if we use base 12, the digits of the letter will be between 0 and 11 instead of 0 and 9. So for this, we must change the range defined here in both digit and digit 1. So we will put it till base minus 1 in both of them. And also we have to change this constraint of the sum. So we have to change the base 10 with the new base. So the thousands will be base cube. The hundreds will be base square, and so on. Square. Cube, up and base 4. And that's it. So we save and run it again. And now we can see that we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different solutions. Nice. If we try now changing the solver from satisfy to minimize, let's say, the sum of sent, for example, let's say that we minimize this expression, the sum that the variables S, E, N, and D made. We save and we run it again, now minimizing this. And we obtain only one solution again, because this is the most optimal one according to this objective. And what happens if we change the base to 8, for example? Well, if we run, we obtain unsatisfiable. That means that there is no solution for this problem, because the minimum solution is with base 9. With base 8 or less, we don't get any solution. Another interesting thing is what happens if we don't put a value on this parameter. So if we run, we can see that Minizinc asks us for those parameters that have not been specified. So we can just write here the parameter value, for example, 12. And it will run normally with this value specified. Another way, more interesting when you have several parameters and want to try different problem configurations, is to define a data file with these parameters. So we click on File, New Data. And here in this data file, we specified of parameters, in this case, base equals whatever number you want. And we save this in the same folder as the model with the extension dzn. For example, let's call it data.dzn. And now back on the model, if we click on Run, now we have a new tab here that's called Select Data File, where we can select this data file we just created and run the model with it. And it works again the same. Finally, in order to organize all your models and data files, you can click in the Show Project Explorer, and here you will see all the models and data files you have created inside this specific session or project. So in order to save all of this, you click on File, Save Project, and that will save the project you are now working in. You put it a name and an extension MZP. And with that, it's already saved. So now if you close this project and go to the folder where it is, you click on it. And then exactly the same session you have before will open, as you let it the last time you save. And with that, all for now. I hope this will make you easier to start using Minizinc and its ID. Thanks for watching, and bye.